Hello everybody, Jack here, and today I'm going to be talking about troubleshooting a common problem with a Hyperx Quadcast microphone. The most important thing that you can understand is that plug right there. It's going to be one of the most fragile things in your microphone. If you're unplugging your microphone, do it here. Unplug this end. You want to put all the pressure on this plug because it's much easier to replace and much more durable. The plug in the back, the smaller one, is prone to bending and becoming weak over time. As you can see, mine is pretty bent. That's gonna be really important because if that plug gets screwed, then you can't do anything with software. The most common issue with this specific microphone is a problem where the device screws up its firmware and then causes Windows to treat it like it's a generic audio device. When this happens, you're gonna notice that your microphone is way too loud. It sounds really garbled. You're just gonna be recording, but then suddenly you find that the device name has changed. Usually, this is a plug-and-play mic that will be labeled HyperX Quadcast in Windows 10. However, once the firmware chip or whatever it is in the microphone fails, then Windows is going to view it as a USB advanced audio device. And this means that the firmware chip in the microphone has failed. And at this point, it's going to reset the settings in Windows. And it's going to make the gain much, much higher. So what you need to do is go into Windows and reduce the gain, and I'll show you how to do that right now. If your microphone is way too loud and showing up on your computer as USB advanced audio device, it's very easy to fix it. To do so in Windows 10, go into the search bar and type in sound. Click on sound settings. From here, you want to scroll down and look at the input sound. You'll notice that mine says HyperX Quadcast. That's simply because I renamed it. Luckily, the quality of the mic doesn't seem to be affected by this problem. It's only the gain that gets way too high. So, by simply changing the name here and setting the volume of the microphone to between 40 and 50. I have it at 45, and I found that now it functions almost identically to how it was before. Another way to test the mic and make sure that it's at the right settings is to use some kind of audio program that monitors your audio levels. When the microphone has this problem, you'll find that the audio bar looks like this. It's constantly red, sounds really, really garbled. And that's because the gain in the mic is way too high, and you have to reduce it a lot. So all you have to do to fix that problem is use your Windows settings as I showed you earlier. And once you do that, then your gain should only be too high if the knob on the microphone is turned all the way up like it is right now. But usually you don't need that much and this is an appropriate audio level. In general, your audio should be as loud as possible without sounding garbled and distorted. This is because people listen to content on different devices and most of the world uses cell phones with shitty speakers. So the louder your audio is, the more likely a mobile user is to actually be able to hear your content. If you've ever watched a video and you've noticed that on a computer with like good speakers, you can hear the video fine, but when you try and use it on like a crappy cell phone, you just can't hear what people are saying. It's because the volume of the recorded audio wasn't loud enough. It's really important that your audio is as loud as possible without sounding distorted and garbled. All right? But for me making these videos, as long as I set the volume level down in Windows to 45, it's behaving exactly like it used to, except now it has a different name. If you liked this video, please check out my other videos. I've got a lot of tutorials about making macros and various other computer software. And if you want to check out my website, you can send me a tutorial request. If there's something you want to learn about, but there's just not enough tutorials that you like, let me know what the name of the software is you're trying to learn, and if I'm able to, I'll make a tutorial just for you. All right, everybody, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Ciao! You can also check out my other videos about using computer macros. If you spend 8 to 10 hours a day on a computer, you should know about macros. You can get more of that day back into your hands and spend it doing whatever it is you actually want to do. Think about it.